Aloha, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, along with Dick Vitale, and welcome to the beautiful island of Maui for this first round game of the EA Sports Maui Invitational Tournament between the BYU Cougars and the Houston Cougars. There's a look, Dick, at the starting lineups.
I'll tell you, the starting five isn't always your five best players. That's one thing a lot of people don't understand.
All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go. Houston controls the tip for a chance at drawing first blood. Moving it around the perimeter.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
In the paint for the bucket. Goes. Good cut. Great pass right there.
Brad, those are the type of reads you look for in practice.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
They work it around the perimeter. In the lane. They get it to go. Now they work it around the perimeter. He goes up with it. Can't connect. Terry handles the pass. They go into the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. Missed the jumper. On the left side. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Turnaround jumper.
I'll tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Lockhart receives the ball. Swatted away. Gave it up. From the corner. Nails the J.
He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
On the left side, looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the elbow, off the mark. Got it down on the low block. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. On the left side. Goes up with a shot. Off the mark. Harper receives the pass.
Inside.
He throws it up from downtown. That's definitely not the shot they were looking for, Dick.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Yeah, we've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. We'll be right back. Dick Vitale and Brad Nessler with you here, ready for the inbound after that timeout. A little two-man action. Tries for two. That was nice. On the dribble, gives it up. For two. Buried it. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Gets the J to fall. He shoots from the baseline and off the mark. Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. Jumper won't go. Hebert receives the pass. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the outside. He tries the jumper. They can't seem to get the ball to go in tonight, Dick.
They have to start making better passes and start going towards the basket more. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
Look at that spacing.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
He puts up the J. The Cougars have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
And come up short. Pushes it up. He attempts the jump shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up. Can't connect. Buries it home. Great strength on that drive.
Well, he spotted an opening and he just absolutely great first step and he exploded to the goal.
And they burn a timeout here. We'll have more NCAA coverage coming up in a moment. We get ready to bounce back into action here. Top of the key. He shoots from the top of the key. And score it. On the outside. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
Throws it up. Goes up for two. Dumps it in. Tries for two. Makes it. Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
Weathers receives the ball. Takes his jumper. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
Here comes the ball screen. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. For two. Got it. Great drive and dish right there.
Hey, getting into the lane and kicking it out for an open look. Hey, they've been able to convert.
Takes the fadeaway jumper. He misses the fadeaway. Missed the jumper. It around the arc, shoots from outside. They get it to go. On the left side, isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. With the jumper,
excellent jump shot right there. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Turnaround jumper. Nope. Strong rebound.
Then they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
We're at the 7-minute mark. Nails the jumper. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
This team is playing great team basketball. They make it really tough for the opposition. If they can't keep this up, they'll all be happy once the final buzzer sounds.
On the left side, he shoots from the deep corner. Off the mark. Weathers receives the ball. Gave it up. Outside jumper. Knocks it down. The Cougars have a player spotting up on the three. Puts up the J. The missed shot. Weathers handles the pass. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. Great shot. They move it into the front court. We're at the 6-minute mark. On the right side, looking for a good shot. He tries the three. Off the mark. Down inside. Goes up for two. Busts the J. Adam. Momentary look from three-point land. He shoots the jumper. These rims are giving them trouble, Dick. They can't get anything to drop.
Confidence has got to be an issue now, Brad. They aren't shooting the ball with any confidence whatsoever. It's Brick City, USA.
Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. And score it. About 5 minutes remaining. And they burn a timeout here. We'll have more NCAA coverage coming up in a moment. The Cougars are down as we take a break. Timeout on the floor. It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you got to think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
On the left side. Turnover committed by the senior. He starts the fast break. Tries for two. Nice shot. They work the perimeter. Goes up with it.
They're going to find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. Terry handles the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. He attempts the three. Missed it. For two. He gets it to go. This guy can really score in a variety of ways down on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. This guy's a talent. He can face you up, play back to the basket. He's a good rebounder and a solid defender.
Takes a medium-range jumper. They got it. The power forward receives the ball. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Shoots and off the mark. Terry receives the ball. Cross court. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Working around the perimeter. He goes for three. Knocked it down. That's taking it strong to the hoop, right, Dick?
Well, those aggressive moves to the basket are what this offense is all about.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries the three ball. Scores it. The Cougars got some good ball reversal there.
Hey, I'm so impressed with the offensive execution. Beautiful ball movement. The ball reversals are getting them some great, great looks.
He puts up the J. The Cougars have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
For the bucket. No. About 2 minutes remaining. Inside. Takes the jumper. Nope. Number 34 with the ball. With the J. Nails the jumper. There's the pick. There's the roll. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Missed the jumper.
Up and inside.
He shoots from the corner. And come up short. Puts up the jumper. The missed shot. Parker picks up the foul. First team foul. Kent has been getting it done in all sorts of ways out there, Dick.
I tell you, he's been awesome. All over the court, making it happen for his team. Let's see if he can keep it up and get the W to go along with his great individual performance.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful is a big bonus.
Terry goes to the line for the first time. He gets it to go.
Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Traps in place, Dick. One minute left to go. Now they're into it. That's got some people out of their seats.
What a reaction, Brad. The fans are loving it.
They're set to throw it in from the side. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot. He did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Goes up for two. He couldn't get it to fall.
Hey, as a coach, you really like to see your kids get up and challenge shots like that.
A lot of times, a challenge is enough to make the offensive player change their shot in the air. Trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. That's good. Shot clock is dead. They work it into a double team on the post. Off the mark. Drains the shot. With the bomb. At the end of the first half, the Cougars lead by 9. And while we get a moment here, let's take a look at the keys for each of these teams today.
I've been really impressed with just how hard both teams are playing. These numbers show you how they've been performing.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. On the outside. For two. Shot off. Cross court. Stop and pop. Gets the J to fall. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Cougars are really delivering on one of the points of emphasis that Dick brought up, establishing that inside game. The coaching staff is happy with what the team has been able to accomplish in this regard. It's worked so far, so look for it to continue in the second half.
All right, thanks, Erin.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad. Look at that spacing.
With a bucket, with the layup. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
Hebert receives the pass for the deuce. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way.
Nice low post play. Good entry to the box.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
In the post. Pitt is feeling it right now.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two with a layup. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him, and I'd see what happens.
Inside. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He drains the shot.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
On the outside.
There's the trap.
He tries the jumper. Off the mark. On the left side. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
The Cougars have put together a real team effort so far, Dick.
When you have guys that want to win, you're going to get different players stepping up in different ways. When it's about the W, individual numbers aren't important.
Jumper. Missed it. Goes up with the shot. He buries the jumper. They'll work it around the arc. Blocks the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. Who wants it? And he saves it. And the ball is dribbled out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Gave it up. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Great double team. Really explosive.
How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
Doing a wonderful job putting the ball on the floor and getting into the painted area.
There's a double team waiting there. Jumper. Bust the jumper. Stolen. Hit. Modest play is having a negative effect on his composure. Emotionally, he couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
Brad, he's in what many people call a funk. Emotionally, he's got to turn things around.
He pulls up with a jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
If everyone else is covered, give it to the guy in the stands. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
On the inside for two. Off the glass and no good. The power forward handles the feed. He goes up with a jumper. He knocks down the jumper. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Tries for two. Oh, yes. The small forward gets the ball.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from the top of the key. In and out. Trying to pack it inside. He puts up the J. Missed the jumper. On the right side. Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Change of possession. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Looking for a good shot. For two. Not there. What are some of the things that up-tempo teams will look to do, Dick?
One thing which stands out in my mind is the type of defense they play. Often up-tempo teams will press, trap, and disrupt the offense at every chance they get.
For the bucket. He can't get the hoop to fall. Weathers receives the ball. They've got a player spotting up on the three. Cross court.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, they might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. From beyond the arc, he has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
Up the J. A severe offensive drought for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad.
Dumps it in. Sets a screen for his teammate. Looking for a good shot. He attempts the jump shot. Nails a sweet jumper. Momentary look from three-point land. For the deuce. Off the glass. He blocks the shot. Frank saves it. Tries for two. Scores it. Around 8 minutes remaining. Working it around the perimeter. He gets the bucket to fall. For two. Off the glass and no good. Goes up with it. Knocked it down. The center gets the ball. Dumps it in. Goes up. Can't connect. Rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
It's 7 minutes left on the game clock. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. The small forward gets the pass. The Cougars are going to move away from their preferred style of play and look at playing a bit more in the half court here, Dick. They've got a lead to protect.
At this point, playing in the half.
Rejected. And we're going the other way. How about this one, Dick?
Hey, up and away, Mr. Nestler. That's how you go strong to the basket.
The Cougars have no choice but to switch their style of play now, Dick. The clock's winding down, and they need some points in a hurry.
You got it, Brad. They may have to extend their defense and really look to trap in order to force some turnovers. They need points.
They work the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Gets the J to fall. On the right side. For two. No good. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Perimeter.
Double team now, bad angle.
Goes up for two. The layup is good. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
For the bucket, lays it up. The Cougars are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got the ball into the high post, and the defense couldn't react on time, Brad.
Cross court. He fires away. He makes the jumper. On the left side, he shoots from the deep corner. Knocks it down. Dumps it in. Goes up. Nope. Grabs the rebound.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
On the left side, he attempts the trifecta. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. He launches a three. And he can't hit the shot. Got a guy right up on him. He puts it up. He misses. Rejected out of there. Great hustle. Dumps it in. Puts it on the floor and up and under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
Gave it up. He shoots from right of the circle.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. And that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
On the right side. He throws it up from downtown. We're at the 3 minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. With the jumper. He drains the jumper. Erickson receives the ball. He gets it to go. Spivey receives the pass for the bucket. Off the glass. The point guard with the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the deuce. Rims out. Two minutes left on the game clock. Was that beautiful or what? A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
You know, Brad, as a coach, you teach your players to read the defender. And when he's not looking, deliver the pass.
Puts up the J. He misses the J. Pitt handles the feed. Will take the shot. He misses the fadeaway.
Inside.
Takes the jumper. The missed shot. Picked out of the air. Great job of getting down the floor.
Yeah, they halted the fast break.
One minute left to go. He strokes it. It's no good. And they burn a timeout here. We'll have more NCAA coverage coming up in a moment. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Up with the shot. He knocks down the jumper.
High post screen, gonna use it?
The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
Been called, so let's check in with Aaron.
With limited time remaining, it's very important that the players have a clear understanding of what the coach wants them to do when they return to the floor. They'll have to be on the same page, or else it could cost them the game.
Well, Dick, it's always important to come out of a timeout with a game plan, I think.
You know, very important. It's a chance to get your team on the same page, talk about what's happened previously, and what's about to happen in the future. I hate it when teams come out of a timeout, unorganized, and without a plan.
Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
On the baseline. Tries for two.
They have to foul to send them to the line. I hope they miss.
Shot clock is dead. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Inbound from the baseline. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Ball coming in from the sideline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Sideline inbounds. Terry fouls out. And the clock stopped with a foul. They'll throw it in from the side. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. The Cougars go to the line for the first time in this game. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Gets the second shot.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one possession game.
We'll get back to the action here after the timeout.
A 5-point lead could go either way with this much time, Brad.
Oh, it certainly can, Dick. He tries the three ball. Scorches the net with a J. Foul, and that stops the clock again. He steps up to the line. And we're ready to get things back going again after the timeout. He puts it up at the horn. Misses on the trifecta. Well, that concludes our opening round coverage. Make sure you tune in for the semifinal action. It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody. And now here's a look at our players of the game.
Oh, some great performances here tonight. Just some special young men.